The Fortress Envy True 12K inverter is a sleek, powerful, and well-supported unit, but isn't it basically just the EG4 18K PV? So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. This was our first go with some Fortress power products. We have the True 12K inverter as well as their eForce ESS system, which we've had here at the lab for a couple weeks now and we've been playing with the whole time. Now, I'm not sure what you guys are thinking, but our initial impression was, isn't this just the EG4 18K? The screen has moved over, but the interface is exactly the same. It's just a different color. All the terminal connections are the same. The overall build is the same. Even the specs are the same, like exactly the same. The only difference is that somehow this Fortress inverter weighs a couple pounds more. So we were skeptical to say the least, and we don't want you guys to think that we only like EG4 products, but we're gonna be comparing this to the 18K a lot because, I mean, look at it. It's basically the same thing. As always, if we can get any coupon codes out of Fortress, we will leave those in the description down below, as well as links to this month's giveaway and any other information that we think you guys should know. But before we jump into our experience with this guy, we're gonna hit you guys with a super quick spec teardown to get you up to speed on the Fortress Envy True 12K inverter. First up, this thing barely passes the tiny baby lift test. It weighs 127 pounds, which is basically as much as he weighs. He's just too short to actually get it up onto a table. So, fail. It's a 48 volt split phase inverter, meaning it does 120 and 240 volts of output. It's a hybrid inverter, meaning it's capable of running completely off grid, doing grid assist, or even selling power back to the grid. It's got a solar input of 18 kilowatts, and similar to the EG4, it recommends an array of 21 kilowatts to be able to take advantage of that full capacity. It does have a 200 amp AC bypass built directly into it, and it's able to charge up your batteries with 12,000 watts if it's connected to the grid. It's also got a continuous output of 12 kilowatts, and you can parallel 10 of these guys for up to 120 kilowatts of power. The screen is nice. It's a simple, nice touchscreen, and we really like that about it. And overall, the rest of the build is nice. It's a good, true, tried, tested build. You got your rapid shutdown on the side, as well as your Wi-Fi dongle connection, PV isolator switch. The internals of this makes a lot of sense, and we're happy about it. And overall, it's just a well-built, weather-rated, I think this is still the NEMA 4X rating, meaning it's able to be fully outside and weather-resistant. And right now, the price of this thing is $4,895 on ShopSolar's website with our discount code. But is it really worth $5,000? So before we jump into our experience, what we like, what we don't like with this thing, we need to get this out of the way. What is the difference between this and the 18K? We aren't scientists, so we reached out to both EG4 and Fortress and said, hey, why would someone buy this inverter over the other inverter? And their responses were interesting. So first of all, EG4 emailed us back and said, while both units are very similar when it comes to specs, software and support will be much different with the EG4/Lux line of products. These items are tailored to exactly what EG4 wants, rather than just using base software. That was their whole response. As far as that response goes, all I can say is remember it because we're gonna circle back to that. As far as Fortress's answer, it had almost nothing to do with the inverter. They basically said why their ESS battery system was so good, but they really never answered the question why someone should buy this versus the 18K. They said things to us like the Guardian's monitoring abilities, which is part of their battery, seamless integration with the battery and the inverter with the E-Way, which actually isn't true at all. On-off-grid capabilities, they share that. And a list of other things that were basically strictly just about their battery. Basically, what we heard from that email is that they think their battery is the bee's knees, and they really didn't have any real reason why you should buy this over the EG4. So basically, just remember both of those responses, and let's jump into the things that we like about this inverter. So first up, it performed really well in our testing. Surprisingly, it almost performed exactly the same as the 18K. We ran all of our testing with it fully off grid. There was no grid connection. So anything it was doing was strictly battery linked to the inverter. That was it. The idle consumption was about 80 watts, which is weirdly 20 watts higher than the 18K. You can see right here, the battery was showing 1.6 amps on the app. It'll run 12,000 watts all day, has no issue with that, although it does seem to surge a little bit less lengthy than the 18K. If you spike it up, it doesn't last quite that long over the 12,000 watt range. It'll do the same test, it fails at the same spot, it won't start the compressor once it's over basically like a 7,000 watt load. If you get into like an 8,000, 9,000 watt load running, it won't surge the additional 10,000 watts just for a split second to get the compressor running, meaning you're gonna need some help, like a soft start or something like that if you have a giant air conditioner. And everything else is fine. It sounds medium, sounds exactly the same as 18K, pass-through works, everything functions as it should. We also really like the screen. As you guys know, we already went over this. They changed the color to keep it brand specific. It's a green screen instead of the EG4 that has a black screen. But aside from a few missing features inside of this screen that the EG4 does have, it's a great screen. It's very intuitive. You can find everything you need to know very easily by just scrolling around on the pages, clicking stuff. Very straightforward. You almost never need the manual to figure out where settings are. You just find them. And we also like the design of this guy. Well, that's basically the same again. The one thing that's a little different on this is that it doesn't just have knockouts on the back wall and on the bottom. It actually has these threaded weather seal knockouts. So anything that you haven't punched out yet is perfectly sealed. And then anything that you do punch out, you can easily thread a weather tight nut on there and make sure that nothing leaks or anything like that, which you could do with the EG4 one pretty easy, but I like that this comes pre-penetrated. That's a good way to put it. It's got the locks on the door, so no one can just walk over. Your nosy neighbor Tom can't just come over and open up your inverter and start messing with it. And it's weather rated, so it can go outside, which is perfect. Again, same as the EG4, we like that there's breakers and disconnects built directly into this thing. You don't need any additional wiring outside of it if you're gonna set it up off grid. You have everything laid out in there, and it's just nice and comfortable being able to flip off different breakers if you're just doing wiring work or if you're working on anything attached to your system at all. Some products that don't have breakers, I just don't like working on whatever's on the other end of them. It also saves you money when you're setting it up. You don't have to buy them additionally and mount them outside of the inverter on the wall or something like that. And the last thing is actually Fortress's support. Every time I called, they thought I was an installer, so clearly they don't sell a lot to directly to the consumer, but they were very friendly, they were American, they were helpful.
The charge first BB should be deactivated.
Okay, and where is that?
On the charge setting.
Spent over 2 hours on the phone with them, which we're about to get into, but in that time, it was great. Like, they actually treated me really well, they were very helpful. They knew the product very well, and that's one of the most important things with support is, do they actually know the product or are they just reading a manual? In this case, they knew the product well and it was a good call. Remember when EG4 said that these items are tailored exactly to what EG4 wants instead of just using base software? Well, this kind of seems like it's just using base software, and I didn't know how to word that until we got that email, and I'm like, this makes perfect sense. It took us over 2 hours on the phone to get this inverter up and running with the help of support, because it is not a straightforward process, which is weird because it's literally the same thing as the 18K. But the 18K comes pre-programmed to work with EG4 batteries and to do everything that you want it to do. This came like a Rubik's Cube. Like, all the settings were just jumbled. It wasn't even pre-programmed to work with its own brand of batteries. They were saying how it has seamless integration with the eForce ESS system, which is funny because if you actually look at it, you need not one of these pinout changers, but two to get it to communicate with this battery. So basically the battery pinout is so completely different from what the inverter wants that you have to run it through two different adapters to change the pinout twice before it'll even work. And then there's just some other finicky things in there, like it was set to have off-grid functionality shut off when the state of charge is less than 20% and the battery was at 23%, and it was shutting the off-grid function off. And even with support, it took that phone call specifically, was over an hour trying to figure out why it wasn't working. You know, it says shut off at 20, it was at 23, it should have been on. And everybody was like, why is this happening? Our experience with this was, it was the hardest inverter we've ever had to set up. It was very frustrating and it took a lot longer than it should have. And it just seems like if they send it to you with a couple of things pre-programmed in there, it would save you a load of time. We also don't like that the RSD is still slow on this unit. It's just slow on every unit, but it's gotta work within 30 seconds. But in our books, if you have a rapid shutdown, when you press that button, everything should shut off. It shouldn't take almost 30 seconds for everything to shut off. If you're having a problem, by the time this thing shuts off, it's way too late. And the last thing that we don't love about this is that it's slightly more expensive than the 18K, And the 18K is already being beat out by the FlexBoss 21 and the FlexBoss 18. We've made plenty of videos covering how those are like the newer, more innovative inverters, and they kind of put the 18K on the back burner. So the fact that this is still a little bit more expensive, I don't know. If you're getting this, it's a good inverter. Once it's set up and once it's running, it's the EG4 18K PV. It's a great inverter, it works well. And if you're looking and someone's gonna install this in your house for you, or you're talking to some sort of solar contractor, installer, whoever it is, and they're gonna use this product, it's a good product and it works well. If you're on the DIY side of things and you wanna set it up yourself, or you're trying to see, hey, what's the best way for me to spend my money on these products? We would recommend looking at something like the new FlexBoss lineup, because the same thing as with this, as with the 18K, if you're gonna use it in a hybrid situation, you're still gonna need to meet code, which means you're gonna need multiple exterior manual bypass and shutoffs, and you're gonna have to spend money on that stuff and all the wiring. You can get the FlexBoss and the GridBoss. They're a dirty combo, and unfortunately, like, they're really hard to beat right now. It's a good product if you're gonna get it, or it's already happening or whatever, but there is some better, more affordable products out there. The one thing that we really took away from this though was that Fortress's support was amazing, and the company knows a lot about the product. If they do release another inverter that's like the FlexBoss along those lines, or just more competitive, more modernized piece of equipment, I would still keep them on the radar. I would still look into them. We're gonna definitely make sure we get our hands on it, because they clearly are a company that knows, and just having good support and knowing your goes a long way. We will leave some links in the description down below for this month's giveaway, any discounts we can get, links to this, links to the 18K, links to the FlexBoss, links everywhere. That's all we got for you guys. Make sure you're subscribed. I'll catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.